And in today's numbers that matter, 10.4%. That's the percentage of Filipino families that experienced involuntary hunger in the second quarter. Social Weather Stations in its new survey said this was higher than the 9.8% in the previous quarter. The poll ran from June 28 to July 1 with 1,500 adult respondents nationwide.
Now the moon is about to get its first taste of connectivity. Nokia Bell Labs, in cooperation with NASA, is deploying the first cellular network to the moon. Nokia said it has developed a low-power, compact, and space-hardened version of its 4G LTE network that's specifically made to survive the journey and operate under extreme temperature, radiation, and environmental conditions of the lunar surface. The uncrewed robotic mission is scheduled for launch this year. Nokia hopes it will help pave the way for a sustainable human presence on the moon. The property and construction sector has also found a use for artificial intelligence. According to the CEO of HomeCube, an e-commerce platform for home value chain, AI broadens the execution of its projects, giving them a new perspective on productivity.
When I was in the construction sector, there are like a dozen ways, as I said, to build a house. But what if AI can give you 100 ways to build a house, and you can wrap those solutions in an objective function? It just gives more profound perspective how we normally appreciate productivity. AI can also experiment data with the current data, like a synthetic data, to make data more robust.
Bit of a relief from China, its services sector activity growing at a faster pace last month in a sign of resilience for one of the main drivers of the Chinese economy. The kitchen services sector PMI came in at 54.1, higher than the 53.9 in June. This was the sector's seventh straight month of expansion. Kitchen points to a rise in business activity during China's summer travel season. The world's second largest economy showed promise in attempting to rebound from its harsh COVID measures. But that recovery has since lost steam, prompting policymakers to roll out measures to support the economy. Chinese officials remain confident meeting their growth targets of 5% this year.
The United States expressing its concerns over ongoing reclamation projects in Manila Bay. In a statement, the U.S. Embassy in Manila said it is worried over the project's link to a Chinese firm, China Communications Constructions Company, that has been blacklisted in the U.S. for its role in constructing and militarizing artificial islands in the West Philippine Sea. It adds the Chinese company has also been flagged by the World Bank and the Asian Development Bank for engaging in fraudulent business practices. The U.S. Embassy is in talks with the Philippine government to raise issues with the possible long-term and irreversible impacts of the projects on the environment.
A look now at financial markets this Thursday. Major indices in the Asia-Pacific region continued to see declines as the Fitch rating downgrade for the United States triggered a sell-off on Wall Street. We're seeing the Nikkei 225 leading today's losses. The ASX 200 also in the red as Australia's trade surplus in June had slipped to $7.4 billion. But the Chinese market showed resilience thanks to Beijing's better-than-expected services activity growth. Notable share price movements now. Chinese tech stocks under pressure as regulators in Beijing propose limits on the use of smartphones for minors. Jack Ma's Alibaba was down close to 1%, along with Baidu and JD.com. Let's take a look now at futures in Europe. Futures are pointing mostly lower ahead of the Bank of England's interest rate decision, as well as services PMIs from the Eurozone, Germany, and France. The BOE expected to raise rates again, but bets are for a 25 basis point hike instead of the 50 bips last month. Over in Wall Street, futures are flat following Wednesday's sell-off. Investors expected to stay cautious with tech bellwether Apple and e-commerce giant Amazon set to release their earnings results after trade. Data on initial jobs claims, services, PMI, and durable goods orders are also due out.
Now, telco giant PLDT records an 18.5 billion peso net income in the first 6 months of the year. That's 10% higher year on year. Its EBITDA also growing, this time by 3%, reaching 52.1 billion pesos. The company says this was an all-time semestral high. Meanwhile, the energy platform of the Ayala Group, ASIN, says its first half bottom line nearly doubled to 4.2 billion pesos. This follows a boost in net generation due to stronger wind projects, as well as higher operating capacity with testing and commissioning of new projects. For China Bank, its net income in the first half of 2023 climbed 7% to 10.8 billion pesos. This after its net interest income grew 16%. The figures translate to a return on equity of 15.9% and a return on assets of 1.6%. And finally, mining company Nickel Asia saw its first half profit halved to 1.7 billion pesos amid lower nickel ore prices. The firm says Indonesia's boosted production and China's slowdown are hurting demand. As for its revenue, it's also down by 8% year-on-year. More local corporate stories. A subsidiary of Aboitiz Power is entering into a joint venture with Singapore-based Vina Energy to invest in a 102-megawatt wind power project in Rizal and in Laguna. Aboitiz Renewables said this is in line with the group's long-term objective of growing their renewable energy capacity. The greenfield project is expected to begin commercial operations in 2025. Meanwhile, Converge ICT Solutions denied rumors of an alleged minority shareholder sale. A supposed significant minority shareholder with 5% ownership was positioned to sell off shares. But the company noted, since the full sell-off of Coherent Cloud Investments, BV, in 2022, Converge did not have any significant non-public minority shareholder holding more than 5% ownership.